In this video, we are going to use the SunFounder's ESP32 microcontroller to detect a tilt using this tilt switch, and the LED will be turned on or off. Now, when I tilt it, the LED is off, and then when I tilt it back, the LED is on, so we can detect it and use it for our robotics applications. ESP32 starter kit from SunFounder. This is the best ESP32 learning kit from SunFounder. It has this ESP32 microcontroller, which has built-in Wi-Fi and Bluetooth. This board can do everything Arduino Uno can do or many other Arduinos can do, plus extra more features. Because we have Wi-Fi and Bluetooth, the possibilities are endless. You can get connected to the cloud or do the control or read information or values via your mobile device or your desktop or over the cloud from a far location. It comes with a camera extension kit where you can stream the video over Wi-Fi, either through the cloud or to your network. And also it comes with micro SD card where you can save images on the micro SD card, or you can write from the device any information, log the information on the device and read it back. You can power the board using this included 18650 lithium battery. And it has built-in charger where you can connect micro USB and charge the battery. The kit comes with 320 pieces of component that you can learn tons of projects. For this lesson, we are going to use this tilt switch, 520D, SW520D, which has two pins, and we are going to use an LED. We are going to use one 10 kilo ohm resistor and 220 ohm resistor. This 220 ohm resistor will be used with the LED, and then 10 kilo ohm will be used as a pull down resistor for the switch. The tilt switch has a lot of application in robotics arm, in industrial application, or maybe even for bird feeder or for something that is tilted. You can detect it. Once you detect the tilt, and then you can do something. And we are going to connect an LED with a tilt, and when it is tilted, the tilt is detected and the LED is off. When I straighten it back, the LED is, as you can see, is on now. So this is very interesting project. Come to this page, docs.sunfounder.com. Scroll down until you see ESP32, then click on ESP32 Starter Kit Main. On the left side, click on Arduino User. And after that, click 5.2 Tilted. And this is the documentation page for our lesson today. This switch is a can which has a metal ball inside it, and when it is tilted, at certain angle, the metal moves and the connection of current will be broken and we can detect it. We are going to use this, and also we are going to use an LED to turn it on. And here, if we click on this tilt switch, there is a page explaining how it works. And inside it, we have a metal ball with two pins, A and B. And this will act like a switch like this. And when it is tilted, or it is at vertical 90 degree, it is connected. So when you tilt it to the left or right, whatever it is that's not straight, these two wires will be disconnected. And as a result, we have an open switch and we will read zero. In this case, because we have connected the switch to 3.3 volts, here, because it's connected to 3.3 volts, we will always read high or one. The component that we need are our ESP32 board, our ESP32 camera extension board, breadboard, jumper wires, resistor, LED, and the tilt switch itself. All of the components are available as part of the kit from ESP SunFounder. For the input, we use all these pins, and for the output, we can use any of these pins below. We have some pins that can be used with condition. These pins, some of them are called pull-up. these pins, pin 13, 15, 2, and 4, have internal pull-up resistor of 47 kilo ohm, which are connected to high. Pull-up mean high, and then down mean low here. So pin 27, 26, and 33 has internal pull-up resistor of 4.7 kilo ohm, and pin 32 has pull-down of 1 kilo ohm. So these are some strapping pins that they determine on a boot of the device or reset. We should not use them. Here it says do not recommend using those pins. And here is a schematic. We have one LED. The cathode is connected to the ground. The anode of LED is connected to 220 ohm resistor, which we will connect it to pin 26. This LED will turn on when the tilt switch detects the tilt angle, or when we move it to a certain angle. And here is our tilt switch. We are connecting one side of the tilt switch to 3.3 volts and the other side to pin 14. And when the switch is not connected, we don't want this pin to be hanging, so we are connecting it to the ground with high value resistor such as 10 kilo ohm. And when the switch is connected, when I tilt it, then the 3.3 volts will be connected and it won't be short circuited to the ground because this value is very high. And here is the wiring, which I'm going to show you step by step. And this is the code, which I'm going to explain it in the code section. Okay, now let's do the wiring. Holding the LED such that the long pin is on the right side. So this is our positive. Just insert it somewhere on this side of breadboard. So this has been inserted. Now let's insert this resistor. One pin will be connected, as you can see here, to the right pin, and we are connecting it to somewhere on the breadboard. So connect it, and somewhere on the breadboard, doesn't matter where. And we are going to define this blue line as our negative, as it has been labeled here. The blue is our ground or negative. The black wire from the left pin, connected anywhere on this line and connected to the blue. And let's insert our tilt switch. Tilt switch does not have polarity, so it doesn't matter where you connect it or how. So we are connecting it at two pins like that. You cannot connect it like this. It must be connected like this because these lines are all connected. I have separate video on breadboard. The link will be below the video in the description, so you watch that if you don't know how to use it. So I'm inserting it in here. And from the left pin, I'm connecting one resistor of 10 kilo ohm to the ground. This is a 10 kilo ohm resistor connected to the left pin, and then connect it to the ground anywhere. So I'm going to connect it on this side so it's not on my way. Here, this is connected to the ground. We need to connect this yellow wire to the point where the resistor is connected. This is now hanging, and the red wire is connected to the right side, this pin. And then from the ground, we are connecting one black wire. Because these two grounds are connected, they are not connected to anywhere. Now we are getting our ESP32, which is attached to this camera extension. You could use it like this. If you are connecting it directly, it will work perfectly fine. But for me, it's very convenient to just plug it in here and use this. Now, this black is connected to the ground. Ground is the last second pin. And then this red is connected to 3.3 volts. This is 3.3 volts, the last pin on this line. Now we have two pins left, which are for our LED and tilt switch. For that, let's have a look at this diagram here. For the LED, which is the yellow pin, it goes to 26. This will go to pin 26. And 26 is somewhere here. And here, yellow is connected to pin 26. The tilt switch, the blue wire, will be connected to pin 14. And 14 is here. Between the blue and yellow, there should be one hole left. The wiring is now completed. I'm opening Arduino IDE. Let's open our project by clicking on File, Open. On the left side, click on Downloads. Then ESP32 Starter Kit Main on the right side. Double click to open it. Double click on C. Double click on Codes. And search for 5.2. Here it says 5.2 tilt switch. Double click, open it, and then select the file. Click open. Here is a code. We have defined pin 14 for a tilt switch, and the variable we named it is tilt pin of type integer, and we set it to constant so it cannot change. And then we have defined pin 26 as LED pin of type integer, also constant. Tilt state is a variable that is holding the state of a tilt, so it continuously being updated. Inside the setup, which runs from here to here, these lines will run only once. So we define the serial monitor with 115,200, so we can print a text on the serial monitor. Then using the pin mode, we set the tilt pin as an input, so we read the input. And then we use pin mode and LED pin, which we defined at the top of the code, as output. Inside the loop, we use digital write and read the tilt pin, so this is reading either 0 or 1. And the value is stored in a variable called tilt. So this will be either 0 or 1, and we saw it, if it is vertical, it will be 1 continuously, and if it's tilted, it will be 0. Now this is printing the value, whatever we read on the serial monitor. In this line, we have a conditional statement, if tilt state is equal high. So this is the state. If it is high, then we use digital write and LED pin to high, so this will turn on the LED. Else mean, if it is not high, then we say digital write, LED pin low. Then we use digital write, LED pin to low, so the LED will turn off. Now the code will come back here and will go back, and the loop will continue do this. Now, because this will print continuously too much text on the screen, I think we should have some kind of delay here, like 200 milliseconds or so, so the screen is not cluttered. Now let's see how we can select the ESP32 board. We can click here under the select board and type here ESP32DEV. As soon as you type dev, you will see dev board. You can select it and click OK. So the board has been selected. Now we have to select the port. The other way to select the board is click on Tools, Board, ESP32, and select the ESP32 dev module. Now we have to select the port. If I click here, it shows two ports, and I don't know which one belongs to my device. Sometimes you will not see the number properly. So the best way to be sure, right click on the start menu, go to the device manager, and you will see here the ports. If I click on this arrow, it will show me the ports. One is USB serial CH340, one the other is USB serial device. And here, now it's connected. If I disconnect this, one of them disappear. The one that disappeared is my board. So 6 stays and 8 disappeared. if I connect it, so it is my COM port, CH340. Now it is my COM port and I can select it, or I can click on tool port, and here you will see it. You can select whichever you want. Ours is COM8. Now we have successfully selected the board and the port, and this is very important. It must be done first. Now my board is connected and the LED is on after code is uploaded. Let's open the serial monitor here. And as you can see, we are reading 111 because the LED is on. The LED is on and it's not tilted. Now let's tilt it. And as you can see, we are reading 0. Oh, so it becomes 0 and then 1. Now the LED is off. So the LED is corresponding to the value directly, whatever it is. So this way we can detect tilt.